Good morning all. In the last lecture we discussed about canonical ensemble. So did you remember anything from the last lecture? So this is Gibbs canonical distribution. It is also known as Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. So this P alpha is equal to e to the power minus beta E alpha divided by summation e to the power minus beta E alpha. So that's what this canonical distribution is. Let me write that over here so that I can explain it. Yesterday we see the mathematics of that. Today we are going to see the physics of that particular canonical distribution. So what we have this canonical distribution E alpha is equal to e to the power minus beta E alpha divided by summation e to the power minus beta E alpha. And we can write it something like this, is equal to some constant into e to the power minus beta E alpha. So what does that physically means? So what is beta? Beta is 1 over kT. So if I want to write it, it will be some constant multiplied by E alpha divided by kT with a minus sign. We are going to look at the physics of this. What does this signify? Look at this particular quantity. So the exponent of this particular term is something like this, E alpha divided by kT. Now if I fix E alpha to a constant number and if I go on increasing temperature, what will happen to this particular thing? Let me call this exponent some x. This is x. What will happen to x? So x will decrease. And what will happen to e to the power minus x? So the graph will be something like this. This is x. This will be e to the power minus x. It will be an exponentially decaying function, something like this. Now for this value of x, the value of e of x is this much. And for this value of x, the value of e of x is this much. Konsa value x ka jyada hai? Let me call it as x1. And this will be e to the power minus x1, this particular quantity. And this will be x2. And e to the power minus x2 is this quantity. Kaun sa x jyada hai? X1 jyada hai, x2 jyada hai? X increases in this direction. So bada kaun sa hua? X2. And what about, and e to the power x increases in this direction. So kaun sa bada hai? Minus x1 bada hai. So basically kya ho raha hai? Lower the value of x, higher the value of e to the power minus x. So what is happening over here? As temperature increases, x decreases. What is x? X is E alpha divided by kT. So as temperature increases, x will decrease. Then what will happen to e to the power minus x? Will increase. And let me put T is equal to constant. Suppose I am looking at a constant temperature. When e to the power alpha increases, what is going to happen to x? X will increase. And what will happen to e to the power minus x then? It will decrease. Samne hai aapke. So we have these two quantities. Now from these two quantities, we are going to discuss about this distribution. Now suppose, what does this distribution indicate? This distribution indicates something like this. Suppose I have energy levels, some energy levels, and I want to fill up electrons into these energy levels. This P alpha, which is equal to C e to the power minus beta E alpha, this gives probability that the state, this energy correspond to some states, so the energy level is occupied. So if I choose this as E0, this is E1, this is E5, this particular parameter C e to the power minus beta E0, this will give me probability of occupation of the energy level E0. Is energy level ka probability kya hai occupy hone ka? What will be the probability for this energy level E1? So this will be proportional to e to the power minus beta E1. What is the probability of this e to the power minus beta E2? What about this e to the power minus beta E3, and so on and so forth. And over here what we have seen, if energy goes on increasing, e to the power minus x decreases. If energy increases, e to the power minus beta E will decrease. From this, what can you talk about the probability of occupation of higher occupied energy level? Or in other word, from this, which energy level will have less probability of occupation? E0, exactly. So the ground state will be most occupied energy level. That can also be seen from this particular graph. This is the lowest energy. Instead of x, I can write this graph as e to the power minus beta e, and this graph will be something like this, and this is energy. So the lowest energy will have the highest probability of occupation. So this is probability, and as I go on increasing the energy levels, the probability of occupation goes on decreasing. So what we have over here is that at constant temperature, lower energy levels are preferred to be filled. So jo lower energy levels hai, unko preference diya jayega. Now what's going to happen when temperature increases to e to the power e kt? Sorry, minus sign. The probability of occupation goes on increasing. What does that mean for these energy levels? So initially, I have the ground state probability is more to be occupied. And suppose this E4 has some probability, let's say 0.5. So वहाँ पे अगर 10 जगह है तो उसमें से 5 जगह fill up हो गए हैं. So the probability is 0.5. Now what will be the probability of this energy level E4, जो initially 0.5 थी, उसका probability कितना हो जाएगा? If I go on increasing the temperature, बढ़ेगा या कम होगा? It will increase. So the probability increases. Probability increase हो रहा है मतलब क्या है? यहाँ पे more number of electrons are occupied at this particular energy level. वो कहाँ से आ रहे हैं? Yeah, exactly. So when you go on increasing the temperature, electron from the lower energy state, ground states or the first excited state, they will be excited to higher energy states. When temperature increases, electron from ground state and lower energy state will be excited to higher energy state. मैं कुछ बता रहा हूँ क्या? मैं वही तो आप अब तक पढ़ते आ रहे हैं कि when temperature increases, more number of electron will be excited into conduction band. And that's why semiconductors are good conductors of electricity at room temperature. And semiconductors are bad conductor of electricity at 0 degree Kelvin. सुना है ना? वही तो मैं बोल रहा हूँ. What's new in it? New ऐसा है कि if we talk about semiconductors, this is my conduction band, this is my valence band, and this is the band gap. And let's say I'm talking about silicon. For the silicon, the band gap is 1.1 electron volt. So in order to make a transition, this electron over here require a energy of 1.1 electron volt. Agar is electron ke paas 1.1 electron volt energy hai, that time it can go into conduction band. Now at room temperature, it is the amount of thermal energy, or if you like 3 by 2 kT, that will be 3 by 2 into the value of K, 8.61733 into 10 to the power minus 5 electron volt into 300. Temperature in Kelvin is 300 at room temperature. So what will be this number? So that would be 3874 into 10 to the power minus 5 electron volt. This is per Kelvin, this is Kelvin, so this will get cancelled, electron volt. So that would be 0.038 electron volt. So that would be 38 electron. So the thermal energy is 38 milli electron volt. So jo temperature ki wajah se isko jo additional energy milne wali hai, which is 38 milli electron volt. Is electron ko kitna energy chahiye to go to conduction band? To utna energy hai kya thermal energy ki wajah se? Till the electron is making a transition. How? So even if I am providing only 38 milli electron volt of energy, this electron is making transition to excited state. How? There is no energy level. This is forbidden. Does it have anything to do with this Boltzmann distribution? Reason being, there are twofold reasons. The first reason is that this thermal energy is average energy. If I look at the energies of all the electrons, yaha pe number of electrons likh raha hu main on y-axis, on x-axis energy likh raha hu. So the energy will be something like this distribution, some distribution like this. And the average value is 38 milli electron volt. बहुत सारे electrons हैं जिसका energy 38 milli electron volt से कम होगा. But there are still some electrons which will have energy greater than 38 milli electron volt. उसमें से कुछ electrons ऐसे होंगे जिनका energy 1.1 electron volt से ज़्यादा होगा. Those electrons will make a transition from here to here. And जो यहाँ पे जो मैंने distribution दिखाया है, this distribution is given by Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution or canonical distribution. So basically, the reason behind the electron is making a transition from valence band to conduction band is because of this canonical distribution actually. Because the energies of electron is governed by this distribution. The energies of valence band electrons, जो valence band में जो electrons हैं, उनका energy जो है, is controlled by Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. So let's take an example. That time it will be clear to you. Suppose I have two level system. The ground state is at E is equal to 0 electron volt. The gap between ground state and first excited state is 0.5 electron volt. What is the probability that the excited or the first excited energy level will be occupied if temperature is 300 Kelvin, T is equal to 600 Kelvin, T is equal to 1000 Kelvin. So basically I have two energy levels. This is E is equal to 0 and this will be energy E1 which is equal to 0.5 electron volt. कहाँ से लिखा मैंने इसका energy 0.5? Because it is given that the gap between first excited state and ground state is 0.5. So अगर ये 0 है तो ये 0.5 होंगी. ये gap 0.5 electron volt का है. And what is asked is the probability of this energy level and at different temperature that is being asked. How that probability is given? E to the power minus E beta. So let me write that C explicitly. What is that C? E to the power minus beta E divided by summation E to the power minus beta E alpha. Summation is over all the energy levels. So this will be equal to, मुझे probability किसका चाहिए? कौन से energy level का चाहिए? E1 का. So probability of E1, so this will give me E to the power minus beta E1 ऊपर यहाँ पे. You write E alpha ना, P alpha अगर मैं यहाँ पे लिख रहा हूँ, तो you write E alpha over here. So probability E1 का लिख रहा हूँ, तो यहाँ पे E1 रहेगा और नीचे क्या रहेगा? Summation over all the energy states. So कौन से energy states हैं मेरे? E0 and E1. So this will be E to the power minus beta E1, E0 plus E to the power minus beta E1. जितने भी मेरे पास energy level है, उनके ऊपर ये sum होगा. If I multiply डिनोमिनेटर एंड न्यूमोरेटर बाय ई टू द पावर बीटा ई वन तो क्या मिलेगा मुझे टू द पावर माइनस बीटा ई वन इंटू ई टू द पावर माइनस बीटा ई वन डिवाइडेड बाय ई टू द पावर माइनस बीटा ई जीरो सॉरी यहाँ पे प्लस रहेगा इंटू ई टू द पावर बीटा ई वन प्लस ई टू द पावर माइनस बीटा ई वन इंटू ई टू द पावर प्लस बीटा ई वन वट विल बी दिस क्वान्टिटी This will be equal to 1 because it will be e to the power 0. What will be this quantity? So let me write that as it is plus what will be this quantity again? 1. Now put the values of energies E1 and E0. So that would be 1 divided by e to the power minus beta E0. E0 is what? 0. So e to the power 0 that will be equal to 1 into e to the power minus beta E1 plus 1. So this will be 1 divided by e to the power beta e1 this has to be plus yahan pe plus hai na so this has to be plus e1 plus 1 this is the probability that the first energy level will be occupied now put the values inside this equation so e divided by e1 is 0.5 so 0.5 divided by beta is KT. The value of K is 1.380649 into 10 to the power minus 23 joule per Kelvin or I can write it in electron volt as 8.61733 into 10 to the power minus 5 electron volt per Kelvin. So energy किस में दी हुई है यहाँ पे मैंने joules में दिया है क्या इलेक्ट्रॉन वोल्ट में तो आई एम गोइंग टू यूज दिस सो दैट वुड बी 8.61 इनटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 5 इनटू टी टेम्परेचर पहला टेम्परेचर कितना दिया है 300 डिग्री केल्विन इनटू 300 प्लस 1 सो व्हाट दैट वुड बी इक्वल टू 1 डिवाइडेड बाय इनटू द पावर हाउ मच 0.00019 इनटू टू द पावर प्लस 5 plus 1 so this will be equal to 1 divided by e to the power so that would be equal to 1 divided by 1.78 into, so that would be 0.56 into 10 to the power minus 8. This is the probability of occupation of E1 at 300 degree Kelvin. Now you calculate for probability of E1 at the next temperature, 600 Kelvin. So that would be equal to 1 divided by exponential 0.5 divided by 8.61 10 to the power minus 5 into 600 plus 1. Calculate it and let me know what is the value that you are getting. What is the value that you are getting? Come on, kya value mila? ऑर्डर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड बराबर आ रहा है क्या आपका? सो क्या हो रहा है, जैसे जैसे टेम्परेचर बढ़ रहा है वैसे वैसे क्या हो रहा है? यहाँ पे कितना था? 10 टू द पावर माइनस 8 प्रोबेबिलिटी एट 300 डिग्री केल्विन. एट 600 डिग्री केल्विन व्हाट इज द ऑर्डर ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड? 10 टू द पावर माइनस 5. और यहाँ पे 10 टू द पावर माइनस 3. सो द प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ऑक्यूपेशन गोज ऑन इंक्रीजिंग. So that's what I tried to say over here. As you go on increasing the temperature, the higher energy level will have higher probability. So the electrons from lower energy levels will go on into excited states. So as you go on increasing the temperature, the energy level, higher energy level will have higher probability. Let's look at this particular problem now. Suppose I have a system, a two level system only. The energy of the first level is 0, so E0 is equal to 0, and the energy of first energy level is, let's say, 1 electron volt, and I have total number of electrons present in this particular system is 10 to the power 23 electrons. Basically, I am talking about some semiconductor material. This is my valence band, this is my conduction band, some, if you like to call it. And the total number of electrons in the material is 10 to the power 23. Find the number of electrons in E1 when temperature is 300 degree Kelvin, matlab room temperature, 600 degree Kelvin and 1000 degree Kelvin. What will be number of electrons in E0 for all these temperatures? How to approach this particular problem? जब तक आप सोचोगे नहीं तब तक आप उसमें मतलब उस प्रॉब्लम के बारे में सोचोगे नहीं तब तक उसको आप सॉल्व कर नहीं पाओगे. मैंने सिर्फ सॉल्व करके दिया है तो इट विल नॉट बी यूजफुल. अगर कोई दूसरा प्रॉब्लम आएगा तो फिर से यू विल बी स्टार्ट. सो टेल मी हाउ कैन यू सॉल्व दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम? इट्स एक्चुअली वेरी इजी. व्हाट इज दैट? E1 एंड E0 बोथ. और आपको क्या पता है? यू नो द फॉर्मूला फॉर प्रोबेबिलिटी ऑफ ऑक्यूपेशन. सो हाउ पी अल्फा एंड नंबर ऑफ ऑक्यूपाइड आर रिलेटेड. नाउ सपोज आई हैव समथिंग लाइक दिस. आई हैव 100 बॉल्स विथ मी. आई हैव सम बॉक्स. द प्रोबेबिलिटी दैट दिस बॉक्स इज फिल्ड विथ दिस 100 बॉल्स, आउट ऑफ दिस 100 बॉल्स इज 0.1. हाउ मेनी बॉल्स विल बी हियर आउट ऑफ दिस 100? So instead of asking the probability, I am asking the number. So how do you write probability? Probability is number inside this particular box divided by total number. That's what probability is. Probability of occupation is number occupied divided by total number. So the number occupied will be equal to total number into probability. So kitne ball rahenge yahan pe? Out of this 100 balls? 10 balls. So, यहाँ पे भी मुझे क्या पता है? मुझे प्रोबेबिलिटी पता है कैसे फाइंड आउट करना है. मुझे क्या नहीं पता, क्या और क्या पता है? मुझे पता है टोटल नंबर्स कितने हैं. और मुझे क्या फाइंड आउट करना है? मुझे ऑक्यूपाइड नंबर्स फाइंड आउट करने हैं. सो कैन यू डू दिस नाउ? डू इट देन. सो इफ आई डिनोट N0 नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन इन E1 एंड E0 एंड n1 number of electrons in e1 and capital N total number of electrons, then n1 will be equal to how much? Capital N into probability of e1. What is the probability of e1? E to the power, so what will be exponential? Yahan pe e alpha ki jagah pe kya lunga main? Because I am considering n1, so I have to take e1. And in the denominator, dono ka addition, jitne bhi energy level hai unka addition. And now you solve, jaise humne last problem mein kiya tha, it will be equal to n divided by e to the power beta e1 plus 1. Jo last problem mein kiya tha, waise hi I have multiplied and divided by e to the power beta e1. One electron volt hai, e1 ka energy. So that would be 10 to the power 23 hai na? 10 to the power 23 divided by e to the power minus 1 divided by 8.61, correct? K ka value 10 to the power minus 5 plus into temperature is 300 plus 1. So this will be number of electron at 300 degree Kelvin. What will be that number? Ho gaya? 10 to the power 5. Yacha uttar kay ala? Exponent. This exponent, what you got for this exponent? 3.18, correct? Into 10 to the power 16, 7. Okay, 10 to the power 7. Barabar hai. So, yahan pe dekho na. 3.1 into 10 to the power 6. That's okay. See, yahan pe this does not matter a lot because this is a huge number. So, order of magnitude, you look at the order of magnitude. And what about N0? Hamare total number of particle kitne hai? Total number of particle 23 hai. 10 to the power 23 hai. 23 mein se agar 10 to the power 6 agar mere first excited state mein gaye, to baki ke kahan pe rahenge? Ground state mein rahenge na? So, that's why 10 to the power 23 minus 10 to the power 6, wo aata hai 10 to the power, kitna ho gaya? 10 to the power 70. For 600 degree Kelvin. Kitna hai aapka answer? That's okay. You forget about this. Order of magnitude. 10 to the power 50. And N0? 10 to the power 8. What about 1000 Kelvin? You forget about this. Multiplying factor. Order of magnitude. Correct? And this is 10 to the power 5. So, look over here. Kya ho raha hai? So, N1 यहाँ पे मैं लिख रहा हूँ 300 के 600 के एंड 1000 के 600 के लिए N1 था 10 to the power 6, उसके बाद में वो बल्कि हो गया 10 to the power 15 और उसके बाद में वो बल्कि हो गया 10 to the power 18. And N0 was 10 to the power 17, 10 to the power 8, and 10 to the power 5. Right? So what is happening? As temperature goes on increasing, yahan pe temperature badh raha hai. What is happening to N1? What is N1? N1 is number of particles in excited states. So the number of electrons in excited state also goes on increasing. On the other hand, the number of particles in the ground state goes on decreasing as the temperature increases. Kya hai ye? Kya likha hai? Electrons from ground state and lower energy levels will be excited to higher energy levels. That's what we have seen in these particular examples. So, I will give more problems on this particular distribution as an assignment. एनी क्वेश्चंस फ्रॉम योर साइड? जो भी हमने अभी किया है उसके लिए कुछ क्वेश्चंस है क्या आपके? ओके, सो लेट मी फिनिश अप इन 2-3 मिनट्स, देन वी विल स्टार्ट विद ग्रैंड कैनोनिकल एंसेंबल इन द नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. सो वी सेड दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग z, which is equal to summation e to the power minus beta ei or e alpha, whatever you want to call it. If I am summing over all the alphas, it would be e to the power minus beta e alpha. This is called as partition function. And this partition function, it plays a very important role in statistical mechanics. Why? Because all the measurable quantities that I want to find, I can derive using this particular partition function. As an example, the probability P of R is given by e to the power minus beta e alpha divided by z. Right? Similarly, if I were to find out what is the average energy of this particular system, then the average energy of a system, kaise find out karte hain average energy? Average value of anything will be sum over the energy values, if I am talking about energy values, sum it over all the energy values into probability of that energy value. If this is P alpha, then average value will be summation E alpha into P alpha. If I put the values of P alpha in this particular equation, I am going to get summation E to the power minus beta E alpha into E alpha divided by summation E to the power divided by Z. Right? This is what I have got. Now, if Z is equal to summation e to the power minus beta e alpha, what will be dabba z by dabba beta? So that would be dabba by dabba beta of summation over e to the power minus beta e alpha. I can exchange this, and after that I am going to get summation dabba by dabba beta of e to the power minus beta e alpha, which is equal to, this is summation. What is differentiation of e to the power minus beta e alpha with respect to beta? Minus e alpha, summation minus e alpha e to the power minus beta e alpha, right? Correct? So I have got this dabba z by dabba beta is equal to this. So minus dabba z by dabba beta is equal to summation e alpha e to the power minus beta e alpha. Right? Look at this particular term. And look at this particular term. Are they identical? So this average value e will be equal to this minus dabba z by dabba beta divided by z. So I can write it something like this: average value will be equal to 1 over z into, or minus 1 over z into dabba z by dabba beta. So I have expressed the average value of energy in terms of partition function. Similarly, any quantities in statistical mechanics, that can be anything, the mean values, anything, that can be expressed in terms of this partition function. That's the physical significance of this partition function. Now suppose I want to find out an average value of some parameter y. How I am going to find that average value of parameter y? The average value of this parameter y will be summation y alpha into p alpha. As simple as that. So this will be equal to summed over y alpha e to the power minus beta e alpha divided by summed over e to the power minus beta e alpha. Now can't I just cancel out this e to the power minus beta alpha and this e to the power minus beta alpha? Can I do something like that? No, because it is multiplied by y alpha. So that's not possible. Okay. So this is how you find the average value of anything. So if I want to find out average value of energy square, what that will be equal to? Instead of y alpha, put, instead of y, put e. So that would be e alpha square, because e, instead of y I am putting e square, e square, e alpha square, e to the power minus beta e alpha, divided by summation e to the power minus beta e alpha. And can I represent this in terms of partition function? That would be del square by del z square, del square by del beta square of z. क्या होगा मेरा डेल, दैट वुड बी समेशन डेल स्क्वायर बाय डेल बीटा ई टू द पावर माइनस बीटा ई अल्फा. क्या होगा ये, दैट वुड बी ई अल्फा स्क्वायर ई टू द पावर माइनस बीटा ई अल्फा समड ओवर ऑल द वैल्यूज. सो लुक एट दिस. So, this will be equal to del square z by del beta square into 1 over z. We have found energy is equal to minus 1 over z del z by del beta. So, any quantities that I need, thermodynamics or statistical mechanics, that can be represented in terms of this partition function, and that's why this partition function is very very important component. Thank you for your time. We'll see tomorrow. We'll be looking at Grand Canonical Ensemble.